What's up?
Hi. So we're here to talk about A Court of Thorns and Roses by Sarah J. Maas.
Yeah, we are.
What do you know about A Court of Thorns and Roses?
Nothing.
Nothing at all. You know who Rhysand is?
Yeah.
What do you know about Rhysand?
He's Faye.
Yeah, that's really all you need to know. Do you know anything about wingspan jokes?
Nope.
Lucky you.
He has wings?
Yeah.
Gross.
So you read Sarah J. Maas books before.
I did.
You have read most of Throne of Glass except the K-All book.
Yep, that sounds right.
What were your thoughts on Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas?
I don't remember.
So it was a completely forgettable series.
I remember liking some of the characters, but...
But it was really forgettable, because
I really don't remember. Like, I remember, like, almost every scene from Ember, and I read that book. I read that series one time.
Yeah, when you like something, you tend to recall it in conversation regularly, and I've only heard you mention Throne of Glass in the context of, like, you had the smut scene on.
Every single fucking time. Every time. Anytime I'm talking to somebody, the window's open or something, I'm like, oh, fuck. Trying to mute it. Who was the character that I really liked?
Dorian?
Is that it? See, I don't even remember.
Damn! You retain nothing.
Nothing. That's how I remember I liked the guy, and then you find out that this other guy that's likable is his dad.
Gavriel was the dad, and who was the...
See, I don't know.
It was Aelin's cousin that...
Aelin Galifianus.
Gelatinous. Her cousin was the guy that you liked. Adian. Okay, so Adian was the guy that you liked, and then you also liked his daddy.
I mean, it's been years. 3 years ago, right?
Yeah, but again, like, you retain books you actually like.
Yeah.
And
I can recall Papillon, like, I didn't like that book at all.
Okay,
I hated it so much, but...
So you would say that then Throne of Glass is more like a 2.5-3 for you, because
I actually rated it on Goodreads like a 2.
Okay, because...
And I think a couple of the books were like a 1, and I think I gave another one like 4, because it was actually really good.
It was probably
Aiden's best book that I gave a 4.
I actually quite liked certain parts of the fourth book, Queen of Shadows, but mostly it's just because, like, and I kind of like the third book because I like the dynamic between Rowan and Aelin until it became romantic and I was like, y'all need to cool it.
I remember not hating it, honestly. Yeah. Otherwise I wouldn't have kept reading.
It's not the worst. So Throne of Glass and A Court of Thorns and Roses are part of the Massiverse because she has 3 different series. A Court of Thorns and Roses.
Was that unintentional?
It was completely unintentional.
I'm just so ready to flip a bird. Crazy.
A Court of Thorns and Roses, Throne of Glass, and then Crescent City. And they are interconnected a little bit. Because in the seventh book, when Aelin Gelatinous is falling through different worlds, which you probably forgot because it was completely forgettable.
No, I remember that. I actually do remember that.
So one of the people...
She saw Rhysand.
Yeah. She did. Wow, I'm surprised you know this.
I remember that.
A little bit retained.
Does he wear all black clothing?
He does.
Does he have black wings? I feel like this is a trend. Black hair, black eyes.
His eyes are not black. His eyes are purple.
Oh.
You were so close.
I was gonna say, like, the bluest blue.
No, you might actually find him dreamy because his eyes are purple. You like purple.
It's my favorite color.
So
nice makeup, by the way.
Thank you.
For me?
A Court of Thorns and Roses is written in first person. Meanwhile, Throne of Glass is written in third. So we hear from the main character, which, to be honest, is kind of a nightmare because Farrah sucks.
How's the internal monologue?
Garbage. So Farrah and her family live in Perithian. Wait, is the whole continent called Perithian? There's a continent, and on the bottom of the continent, in the toilet section. Ain't no eggs here because everybody's poor. Well, just Farrah and her family. So on the bottom of the continent is where the humans lived, and on the top of the continent is where the Fae live. So the Fae get all the nice areas and the humans get jack shit. And there's a line called the Wall where the humans don't cross and the fairies are not supposed to cross, but they do.
But they cross anyway.
They're crossing it, so...
Is there a forbidden love?
Hell yeah, there is. You're goddamn right. So, Farrah, spelled F-E-Y-R-E.
Okay.
Like, Fairy and her family fallen on tough times. They're poor. And she likes to paint, but they can't afford paints because they're poor. They live with her dad. She has 2 sisters who are older than her, Elaine and Nesta. Everybody fucking hates Nesta. I like Nesta because she's always in a bad mood. Bitch, same. And Elaine is stupid and has no personality. So naturally, everybody loves her and I don't get it. Naturally. I think why I hate her is because in fundamentalism, Elaine is like the perfect woman. Farrah runs around hunting while her sisters don't do jack shit and neither does her dad. They're poor, they're hungry. She's like, I'm gonna die if I don't eat soon. You know, like me this afternoon.
Are all the squirrels that she hunts Is there an arrow straight through the eye? Just saying, it sounds kind of familiar.
Katniss, is that you? Sees a deer, a doe, a deer, a female deer.
Straight through the eye.
No, which begs the question, what's the deer eating if the deer's not hungry? Anyway, so she...
This got good.
That's a way better book. So, Raven, God damn it.
Raven, come here. Every time.
Every time. She never does this when I film, but as soon as you show up, she's like, Daddy.
Yeah, she's, are you okay? You look claustrophobic. Do you need help?
Emotional support cat. So she sees a deer and she's like, I'm gonna shoot that deer. And then in the corner of her eye, she first sees a little shadow, which is foreshadowing. Oh shit. She sees something and then she sees a wolf going after the deer. Or is it? It's not. So the wolf is there. She thinks just going after the deer. And she thinks, I wonder if that's a fey wolf because it looks like a possible fey wolf. And she's like, I hate the fey because I'm a human and that's the dynamic. So she shoots the wolf with an ash arrow because ash arrows kill wolves.
Is it made of ash or is it covered in ash?
Ash wood, I guess.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
Ash River Gallatinius, Aelin, yeah. Comma.
That wasn't your best joke.
You're right. Damn. It's okay if you leave me. That was embarrassing. You
can't.
You physically cannot have you cornered. Because she killed a fey wolf and she goes back to her house and then a beastie shows up. Because this, by the way, is a Beauty and the Beast retelling.
Fuck yeah.
This one's for the furries. This dude, this beastie shows up. You murdered the wolf. So a life for the life, which is stated in the treaty that apparently exists between humans and fey.
Sorry.
The wolf ferryman is Tamlin and he lives...
I've heard this name before.
Yes. Yes, you have. I call many people the Tamlin. So Tamlin shows up and he's like, you bitch, you gotta come with me. You whore, you killed that wolf. You find out later, he sent the wolf to get killed because there's a plot afoot.
What a piece of shit.
He is actually a piece of shit. But so is Rhysand.
So Sarah J. Maas. If it wasn't for her, I wouldn't be here.
She's the real villain.
Downstairs playing video games.
Fair enough. Tamlin is the High Lord of the Spring Court. There's a bunch of courts. Do you want to guess what the courts are in Fairyland?
Are they seasons?
Some of them.
Oh.
Spring Court, Autumn Court, Winter Court.
Summer.
God, it's fucking Summer Court. And then there's also Day Court, Night Court, and then Dawn Court.
Mm.
Which Dawn and Day are...
I don't know. You're approaching Stephanie Meyer territory now.
Not Breaking Dawn.
Is it Breaking Day? No, it's not. Breaking Dawn.
Night Court, Family Court.
Is that where Shadow Daddy's from? Night Court?
Yes.
Of course.
Fuck.
What do they have against, like, bright colors?
I don't know.
It's like the one dude can't be, I don't know, fucking, he wears purple?
Well,
what do they have against guys in white suits?
That's a good question. Okay, so he takes her. He's the High Lord of the Night. What?
The guy who wears all black. I'll never understand. Why are they so obsessed with guys that wear the black clothing?
You literally don't wear color. You are what you hate. What have you become?
I got black pants, but... A fucking gray hoodie.
You have black hair and brown eyes, and that's what you made fun of earlier. You are the Shadow Daddy.
That's why you fell for me. I'm the Shadow Daddy in your story.
Damn it, I'm so predictable. He takes her to the Spring Court where he rules everything. By the way, he has a mask permanently glued to his face. I'm so sorry. He has a mask permanently glued to his face.
Okay.
So does his BFF, Lucian, who also has one missing eye. He has a fox mask glued to his face.
I don't think that we can drink and do this.
I don't think we should drink and do this next time. All of the household, including...
I mean, I should.
Yeah.
I'll be...
All of the household, including Tamlin, wear masks, and they learn them because there's a curse affecting the magic, and the masks are magically glued to their faces, okay? She has to go and live there because she killed the wolfie. So they're searching for a cure to
the mask glue?
The mask. It says they're afraid that it might spread to the mortal lands, which
ooh,
I feel
shit.
Like...
shit, yeah.
Yeah, that's a fucking lie, though, and yeah. You find out later. So Fair is like, oh, shit.
Is getting masks.
So Fair, well, that's the thing is...
You can't tell them apart. They're gonna sneak in.
They don't have Shadow Daddy characteristics to differentiate them. The rest of the courts don't have masks glued to their face. It's just Spring Court that does. So, and most of the people are not there. Like, Spring Court's pretty fucking empty. And she's like, where the fuck is your family? And he's like, dead. So
they couldn't take the mask.
So for hundreds of years, for 50 years, they've had masks glued to their face in spring court. And spring court is about spring, so there's like fucking flowers and shit. So she's like, I don't want my family to be starving over in the mortal lands and end up with this plight, whatever the fuck it is. So Tamlin's like, oh, don't worry, I'll take care of your family. And they start fucking flirting and shit, right? Because obviously,
of course,
he is the beast and she is the beauty.
Everyone's horny.
Everybody's horny all the fucking time.
But he deserves a female. I remember that line. Every woman deserves a female.
Sarah J. Maas is a fucking menace for that. By the way, Farrah can't read. Farrah was raised in a city run by Moms for Liberty, and as such,
she's from Florida?
Yes, she cannot read.
From Florida?
So he tells her, I'll teach you to read, and also you can like paint and shit, because you've got nothing the fuck else going on, because you got kidnapped from your family for killing a wolf.
Loser.
And they start hanging out. Then she's like, I feel like these dudes, Tamlin and Lucien, Fox Mask guy, are fucking lying to me about some shit. Because they won't answer all her questions. And it's awkward. And there's this other chick, Alice, who lives there, who's like the house caretaker. She's like, Alice, what the fuck's going on? And Alice is like, I ain't saying shit. So she's like, I feel like there's something fishy going on. And she keeps having these like dreams about this redheaded bitch. Okay? Okay.
Is that your one you like?
No. I mean, she sucks as much as everybody else in this series. 100 years ago, he sent his fae to spy and infiltrate the other High Fae courts. Then 50 years ago, one of his commanders disobeyed him, and then Farrah gets attacked, and Tamlin comes to her rescue, you know, kind of like the wolves thing in Beauty and the Beast, and she's like, oh my god, he saved me! And, you know, they start flirting some more. Weird stuff starts happening, like, one of the summer court fairies is found with their wings ripped off, dying, and he's like, she took them! And Farrah's like, who's she? Overhearing shit about some woman who's, like, evil, and nobody will tell her anything, and then she finds out that they are talking about the so-called self-proclaimed Queen of Perithian, Amarantha. You know, Amaranth, mm-hmm. That grain that we used to eat when we were vegan? Yeah. Like that, but with an A on the end. So
I just think it's crazy that, like, they're just, they don't want to tell their shit.
They don't. They
like, why are you guys all running? Nothing. The fucking fire. They don't give a shit.
Why do you have masks glued to your face? What mask?
Shut up. Why don't you?
The question is, why don't you have a mask? It's actually really comfortable.
Where's the bathroom at in this place? I don't know. I just got here. Been here for like three days. I don't know.
Been here for like 300 years. I don't know. Okay, so there's a solstice, because solstice is always a thing in Fae land. And there's a celebration called Calamity Ganon. Calan May. It's Calan May. Farrah and Tamlin sneak off and kiss. Wait, no, that's not Calan May. Calan May comes later.
Oh.
It's when Tamlin.
You're doing a great job.
Thank you so much. I'm really good at my job. Calan May is when Tamlin gets super horny because he's spring court. I don't understand. Okay. I don't fucking know. Don't ask me.
Is that the only time?
He could only get a boner on Calan May. Yes. Mm. They kiss, right? Obviously that was gonna happen. A romance is cultivated. And then the next day, a really hot dude shows up, and he is Rhysand, High Lord of the Night Court. Mm-hmm. And he shows up.
He's the Velvet Rapsteel.
Yeah. I mean, his Velvet Rapsteel does not show up in this book, though.
Oh, that's too bad.
She's not cultivating a romance with him yet.
It's so there, it's just not.
It's there, it's just
she
not.
Hasn't seen it yet.
Unwrapped.
Unsheathed.
Oh, God. He doesn't unsheath in this book.
Slam to the hilt.
Oh, my God. The fact that I have complained about this so much that you remember so is so sad.
It's been an ongoing joke for a long time. That's how I remember.
This is so sad. Sarah J. Maas is a menace. Rhysand allegedly works for Amarantha, but that's kind of like a, it's complicated.
Love those.
He like realizes that she's there and threatens her, and he's like, what's your name? And she's like, Claire. She just names like some random ass chick in her town. Goes back home, as you know, Belle in Beauty and the Beast does. And when she goes back
Claire's
home.
Claire's dead.
Claire's fucking gone. Jesus. No, Claire's gone, and her whole fucking family, her family's gone. Their house is like burned to the ground. Farrah is like, something's not right. And so she
goes. I didn't do shit.
She goes back.
I didn't do fucking shit.
Wait, but this, I don't remember when this happens, but oh, Callan May. Okay, so Callan May happens because spring, you know how like bunnies, like fucking spring? It's kind of like that. Okay, so spring, sure. He gets super horny in spring. He has to fuck somebody, but he doesn't. I think he sends Lucien to go fuck somebody. Tamlin?
On his behalf.
He does. He sends his pal. He's like, take one for the team and go fuck somebody because I'm really into Farrah and I don't want to go fuck somebody else, even though it's literally my job as High Lord of the Spring Court. So he goes and finds Farrah and he's like, I know I've been super chill this whole time, but I am really fucking horny. They don't, he like bites her neck really aggressively.
Now he has to wait until next year.
Fucking he idiot. Like bites her neck really aggressively.
This is why it's important to discuss things.
They do end up having sex at some point. Then she goes home.
Next year?
No.
Oh, okay.
Then...
Later that night?
No.
Like, biting's not on the table. Fuck her.
She's really into the biting. They end up having sex at some point. He's got velvet wrap steel because he obviously is a man. No, sorry. He's not a man. He's a male. He's a fey male. And all of them have velvet wrap steel. I've never seen a time in a fey book where the fey male does not have velvet wrap steel that is as long as a fucking award-winning size eggplant, okay? She, I don't remember why, but he's like, Farrah, you have to go home. And she's like, I don't really want to go home. I want to stay here. I kind of feel at home here. And he's like, fuck off.
They all have huge cocks here. I'm not trying to leave.
I actually found out that everybody here is a huge schlong, and I really don't want to leave
anymore.
For
some reason, they're interested in my human ass.
So he's like, you actually got to get the fuck out. So he hit it and quit it. Just kidding. So she skedaddles back over the wall to the human, the mortal realm. And Claire, the family... Claire's family, the lady she gave the name of,
is dead.
Dead. Manor burned to the ground. And Claire's gone.
Manor.
Yeah. So, no, seriously, like, some of the people are not poor.
Oh.
She and her family just are. Apparently there's no socialism there. It's all capitalist bullshit. And
I would have dropped her name, too.
Ferris said, eat the rich.
Anytime you get in trouble, you always drop the rich kid's name.
Absolutely.
Every time.
I absolutely did that.
They can afford the ticket.
No, you remember in high school when we were late, we'd have to go to the lunchroom and we'd have to give a name?
Yeah.
Okay, I would be given other people's names.
Yeah.
Margaret. That's not
Hope
my
you're
name.
Not watching.
Sorry, Margaret.
It's the only time I've looked at the camera. I think in the three videos, that's the only time.
She's like hanging out with her family. She's like, I actually don't want to be here. Assumedly because, you know, all the good dick is in Perithian, the fey world. She's like, I really just want to go back. I want to be where the dicks are. So she hops.
Fair.
She, you know, same girl. So she hops back over the wall. I mean, rides back over. And she gets back to the manor and Lucien and Tamlin are gone. So all the dick has left the building.
That sucks.
And she runs into Alice, the housekeeper. And she's like, Alice, what the fuck is going on? Where the fuck is the dick? This is when we finally get the answer. We've been sitting around fucking...
She was desperate to spill the tea then. She was waiting for somebody.
She was waiting for those dudes to leave the building. So Queen Amarantha, showed up as an emissary from a different continent called Highburn. Do you remember in Throne of Glass how the king did not have a name?
Mm-hmm.
Neither does the king of Highburn. It's just an ongoing thing with Sarah J. Maas. She doesn't want a fucking name, dude.
It's her thing. It's
so, fresh. King of Highburn sent Amarantha over as an emissary to Perithian. King of Highburn's also fey. Sent Amarantha, and Amarantha was like, I kind of fucking like it here. So, 100 years ago, she shows up. She fights in a mortal war beside her sister, Clithia, which I feel like that's way too close to the word clit to not be hilarious, but whatever.
So, let me circle back. I'd rather him not have a name than, like, hype up the name drop and it be Alexander.
Fucking fair.
All right, cool, bro.
We were
TV show.
Waiting for that
yeah.
that whole time. Alexander? Why? Okay, so Clithia. I think all the name of my daughter, Chlamydia.
Chlamydia is a beautiful name.
Clithia fell in love with a mortal warrior named Jurian, who eventually betrayed Clithia, allegedly. Amarantha's like, fuck the humans ever since Jurian. She fucking hates Jurian. And she actually has Jurian's eyeball sitting on a necklace around her.
That's fucking cool.
Yeah, so like, in a way, I kind of fuck with Amarantha. In another way, Amarantha's worse than Tamlin because Amarantha's a fucking rapist. Amarantha fell in love with Tamlin and she wanted to make Tamlin her lover and her consort, and Tamlin was like, I don't like you, bitch. I don't want to fuck you. And so all because Tamlin didn't want to fuck a woman, he has a mask glued to his face.
Damn.
Yeah, she said, fuck you. So...
Is it a cute mask?
No. That so sucks. Olive Springcourt was magically unable to tell Farrah this shit. And he was supposed to make a girl fall in love with him.
Like the Beauty and the Beast.
But specifically, he has to find a girl who has killed a fae and then make her fall in love with him. It was very hyper-specific. So he sent his own bros, like his own
fucking... The wolf was fae?
He was a friend of Tamlin's that he was sending out on the front line. Hey, go get killed by some bitch so I can fall in love.
It's fucked up.
It's fucked up.
I'm gonna haunt the shit out of him.
I would.
I'm gonna ghost steal this girl.
So Farrah's like, Alice... By the way, Alice is spelled A-L.
I don't know why the fuck I'm like, why are you reading?
By the way, Alice is spelled A-L-I-S.
Okay.
So Farrah, F-E-Y-R-E, asks Alice, hey, I want to go talk to Amarantha. And Alice is like, absolutely fucking not. So Farrah ends up getting like fucking arrested or some shit and gets taken to Amarantha. And Tamlin, when he sees her, is like, I don't know that bitch.
Never seen her in my life.
I've never seen that bitch in my life. Farrah has to make a deal with the queen, Amarantha. She has to complete her wishes three tasks once a month. And if she does, then Tamlin and all of the fake courts will be free. Or she can solve Amarantha's riddle and they will be freed immediately. So it's either do the three tasks or solve the riddle.
Do I get to hear the riddle first?
Let me read you the riddle and see if you get the answer. Hold on.
If I get this, that's it.
There are those who seek me a lifetime, but never we meet. And those I kiss, but who trample beneath ungrateful feet. At those I seem to favor the clever and the fair, but I bless all those who are brave enough to dare. By large, my ministrations are soft-handed and sweet, but scorned I become a difficult beast to defeat. For though each of my strikes land a powerful blow, when I kill, I do it slow.
I have no clue.
The answer is love.
Motherfuck. I mean, it's not a bad riddle.
But Farrah's stupid as fuck, and she doesn't get it.
Did my best Farrah impression there. It's fucking stumped.
Nothing prepared me for that joke. That was good. Damn, Amarantha would have beat your ass. Well, it doesn't help that it wasn't written down, and even if it was, Farrah couldn't read it.
Give me like 5 minutes, I'll figure it out.
Because Farrah can't read, and that's part of the problem here. I just chugged the alcohol. What am I smelling? It smells weird in here. Okay, so she completes the first task, which I don't remember what that is. It might be the worm, which, by the way, do you remember some word from, what? Worm from SpongeBob? The...
The old worm?
No.
The old one? Is it a wheelchair?
No.
The
Midgard worm. SpongeBob.
The pizza worm?
No. Alaskan bullworm. Everybody says that the Midgard worm from A Court of Thorns and Roses is the Alaskan bullworm. Alaskan bullworm.
Yeah, that one. I remember that one.
Okay, so everybody makes the joke that the so Farrah's in a fucking maze running from the Alaskan bullworm. And Lucian's like there and he's calling out, why?
Huh.
Why are you so low?
Nothing. I'm just...
Lucian's there and he's calling out directions like, run, bitch! On your left! Like Captain America or some shit.
Mm.
And so she ends up, there's like a bunch of bones from the fucking, no thanks, from the Alaskan bullworm killing a bunch of other shit. And she ends up like fucking throwing a bone at Amarantha, like, fuck you, bitch. Anyway, she kills the Alaskan bullworm. But she gets hurt.
Patrick would be upset.
I didn't actually watch enough SpongeBob. Okay, so she kills it and then she gets a wound and it gets infected. And who shows up? In her...
Resan.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, he shows up.
Good.
By the way, on Callan May, when he showed up...
glides down, like...
Yeah, no. When he showed up on Callan May, there were a bunch of weird fucking gross fae who were, like, trying to, like, I don't know, I think, like, sexually assault Farrah. He says to her, there you are, I've been looking for you. Well, it turns out he had been looking for her ass because he'd been dreaming of her.
Because she got that ass?
Because she got that ass, ma. He'd been dreaming of her, so when he showed up, he, like, acted, like, super cool. Went inside, he was like, oh, shit, oh, shit, oh, shit, oh, shit, she's so hot. Oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God. It's literally the girl of my dreams.
Oh, my God, a fucking human?
This is so embarrassing for me. So, Rhysand shows up, and he's like, I'll heal you, but I'm gonna make a deal with you. And he, like, I think hurts her arm further. I don't know.
I'm not calling her at all.
People take issue with this scene because it's, like, shitty on Rhysand's part. But I don't really remember the details. All I remember is, fuck Rhysand. Stop. You're gonna make her show up and she's gonna fuck with the camera. Stop!
I'm not. I'm not doing anything.
You're doing the fingers! He's over here like, come here.
She's so cute right now though. Look at her.
Oh my god. He heals her and he's like, but we gotta make a fucking deal. You have to spend a week of every month with me for the rest of your life.
That's what she has to do to be saved? You gotta go on a date with me.
You have to.
Otherwise, I'm just gonna dip.
No, it's like, you have to hang out with me for a week for totally, I'm a bad guy. Like, totally bad purposes. Like,
I really don't fucking care.
I don't like you, and I guess I'll heal you.
Spend time with me for a little bit, I guess.
Just hang out with me for a week.
So I can hate you, but like up close.
Up close. I wanna hate you to your face for a week every month for the rest of your life.
I'm gonna watch you. I wanna watch you grow old.
I hate you so much. I wanna see you once a month.
He's just trying to smash.
Yeah.
But he's like super chill about it.
So he puts a tattoo on her. Magic tattoo. Yeah, he puts a magic tattoo and there's a fucking eyeball on her hand. And sometimes he uses it to wink at her. Why don't you do nice things for me like that?
I don't want to do that.
I would do anything. So she can't, like, you know, beat off with that hand without technically. What? She can't, you know, like, flick the bean with that hand, technically.
Cut all this out.
Without her being. With her essentially having sex with Reesan because he's on her hand.
She has two hands.
I don't know, maybe she's a two-handed
maybe
girl.
Maybe she's ambidextrous or she better learn to do it with her left hand.
Okay, so that all marks right. Their deal. And after that, Reesan every night forces her to be his escort. He sends his little fae fairy ladies into her room to paint her up and put on this like super skimpy outfit that basically just covers her nipples and her hoo-ha, and that's it. And he makes her like sit on his lap all night while Tamlin watches. So what would you do if some dude did that to me?
Kill him.
So romantic. I love you. So
probably just move on. She's doing that. Damn, I fumbled.
So her second task is to solve a different riddle, but she can't read.
Yeah.
So Reesan helps her through the Reesan helps her.
That's why she failed the first one.
Oh, well, no.
She couldn't even read it.
Amarantha doesn't know that she can't read, but Reesan figures it out and he helps her.
What's wrong with her ear? It popped back. Her ear was all inside out. I was so concerned.
She thinks we're stupid as fuck right now. She's like, pet me, but I think y'all are worthless.
Likewise. I even have a black cat.
Oh my god, you are ultimate shadow daddy. Somebody said we need shadow daddy t-shirts. I might just put your face on them.
You can have my silhouette, that's it.
So he says to her, I helped you with the riddle. I actually want to get the fuck out of here. Amaranth is the worst, and I want to get the fuck out of here. By the way, they're living on a place called Under the Mountain. There's a mountain.
Is it under a mountain?
It is. Oh, there's okay. A literal mountain, and they are under it.
Would have been confused if it wasn't.
Yeah, so.
It's a bar.
It's a bar?
The only other thing that makes sense.
No, yeah, they're in a bar and the mountain, there's just a picture of the guy from Game of Thrones there underneath him. He admits to her he wants to be free of Amarantha. Third task, she has to kill three innocent fae. So they come out and she kills the first two, but when they take off the head covering of the third fae, it's Tamlin. She doesn't know what to do.
I thought you said he killed them.
She kills the first two fae, but she doesn't kill Tamlin. Alaskan Bullworm, oh my god, I did it again! Alaskan Bullworm, the other riddle, which I don't know, had some sort of thing, and then kill innocent people, and one of them's Tamlin. And she says, no, I'm not gonna kill Tamlin.
Yeah, but we moved on from that.
No, she still had time. And she shoves a dagger into his chest, and he doesn't die because he is as hard as stone.
And this is a better received series?
It is, yeah. The other one? It's very well loved. What happened is she realizes that Tamlin has a heart of stone, so she's like, I can stab him and he's not gonna die. So she stabs him in the heart, and Amaranth is like, ugh, you technically did it, so you technically won the task. But I'm not actually going to free these bitches. Because I never said I would do that. The alcohol is actually really hitting me right now. She's like, I'm not freeing these bitches, but I am going to break all your bones, you fucking bitch. So she starts breaking all of Farrah's bones. Farrah's like, oh, my bones are being broken. This really sucks.
Oh, my bones are broken.
By the way, is the answer to the riddle love?
Bitch!
Yeah. And immediately after figuring out that magically that breaks the Spring Court, the masks, that, yeah.
You're like, damn, Foxface, you're kind of cute.
Yeah, everybody's hot, so Julian's hot. Yeah. Julian, by the way, I'm going to spoil it for you. Julian is mates with her sister. Her sister was a witch.
I was going to say that.
Rhysand's friend is mates with her other sister.
There's mates?
I'm so sorry. There is. I'm sorry to break this to you, but there is. It's terrible. Wait till I tell you about what happens in A Court of Mist and Fury. Tamlin is like, cool, I can do whatever the fuck I want now. But Amarantha's like, I can still whatever do whatever the fuck I want. So she breaks Amarantha's... What? Amarantha breaks Farrah's neck. Farrah's dead.
It's the main character?
Farrah's soul is watching everything that happens because she's bonded to Rhysand through the eye tattoo.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I forgot about that.
Actually, she's not just bonded to Rhysand through the eye tattoo. They're mates.
Oh, shit.
Not her and Tamlin.
Does everybody else have eye tattoos to spy on their mates? Calling them up like...
No, that's... Hello?
I know you're fapping.
Ring, ring, bitch. That's just a Shadow Daddy only thing.
You gonna share that cupcake? Oh, fuck.
Farrah is watching through the bond. Tamlin kills Amarantha. I think he cuts off her head.
Oh, yeah.
Because he can finally do what he wants. Yeah. And
just use the magic glue. Put it back on. And it worked so well with the masks.
Magic glue Farrah's soul back to her body. The fun and ridiculous magic in this world is that if all the High Lords come together and decide they can use their magic to bring somebody back to life.
Oh.
How this, like...
How convenient.
It is overly convenient.
Let's bring the girl back that we didn't share any of our secrets with.
Because this happens to Farrah, and then they have to do it with Rhysand later.
How many times can they use it a year?
That's my question. I honestly don't know. I don't know what the limits are. It's a stupid thing. Like, she shouldn't have written it that way. So, the High Fae...
You're gonna bring back a fucking human?
Yeah.
A normie?
Yeah, and it makes her into a Fae.
Okay, that's kinda cool.
Isn't it?
I mean, at least it has a fucking purpose.
It could be worse. It could be worse.
But yeah, she was kind of chill.
Wait till you find out how her sisters become
Fae. She was kind of chill. She was fucking everybody. Like, bring her back.
She really liked the Fae dick. I feel like we should keep her around.
Bring her back and let's make her Fae. They live longer or something, I'm assuming. And then she was already hot. She's about to be hotter.
Yeah. Okay, so...
Never mind. It's not cool anymore.
Farrah is traumatized because of what happened. She killed two innocent people.
Tamlin, she killed the fucking wolf at the beginning. She didn't do nothing.
That's a really fucking good point.
Was he guilty?
Not you spotting a plot hole that I never even thought of.
God, I feel so bad. Those two people were innocent. Like, bitch, you didn't know the wolf.
That's a really good point.
He wasn't doing nothing.
He was just running around, paws out.
He was just wolfing around.
He was just trying to hell at the moon in peace. At the end, Farrah sees Rhysand and she's like, you like helped me out and shit, I guess. And he's like, yeah. I'm gonna fuck off back to the Night Court. I don't wanna be here anymore.
No, I'm packing like
he used to get called like Amarantha, what? Amarantha's whore. And because she raped him, which was like awful.
Gross.
So he like, you know, tried to play the part and act like an asshole, but he's like not an asshole.
I have trauma.
Yeah, he
because of course he does. He's Shadow Daddy.
Yeah. Well,
there's always some. I mean,
So at the end, he turns around and he looks at her.
His trauma is valid, is what I was gonna say. It's just
That's the thing.
Shadow Daddy always has.
Rhysand's trauma gets validated while Tamlin's doesn't, and Tamlin gets turned into the villain in the next book, sort of. So
he stole his girl. So.
So Rhysand, while he's looking at Farrah, they're talking. He's like, I'm gonna go back to the Night Court. And then he looks at her, and he like looks at her again, and then he like, and then he stumbled back, and he like nopes the fuck out of there. He like, you know, what is it called?
Teleports
back home. And he hasn't been home in a million years because they've all been stuck under the mountain because of Amarantha. So he hasn't been home in 100 years. He hasn't seen his friends and shit. He hasn't been able to go back home and be, you know, the king of the Night Court because of Amarantha's curse. So he's like gonna go, and then all of a sudden he's like looking at Farrah funny, and it turns out that the reason he was looking at her funny is because that's when their mating bond snapped into place, and it's really stupid.
You didn't have multiple mates?
No.
Only her?
Yeah.
Oh wait, Rhysand was mated to her human side.
No, to her.
He was mated to...
No.
He mated with her when she was human.
No.
And now she's Fae, right? She just got revived.
No, he it snapped into place after she became a Fae.
Oh.
Yeah.
Rhysand's?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Her and Tamlin never had a mating bond.
I thought you were saying Tamlin.
No. Oh. It's Rhysand, Shadow Daddy. Her and Shadow Daddy. But she's
well, I thought that the eye was their bond.
They had a pact bond. They were bonded through the pact, but then they're also that
I'm confused.
They were, yeah. Okay, so they're mates, but she doesn't know. Only he knows. And he goes back home and he's like, oh, fuck. I have to let my mate go back home to the spring court with another man. This fucking sucks. By the way, there was one point when her and Tamlin were making out and Rhysand walked in and he saved her and Tamlin under the mountain from getting fucked up by Amarantha by pretending that he had made out with Pharah. So he he saved their asses, which was nice of him, sure. But also, later on, fuck Rhysand, because he's an anti-choice piece of shit, and I hope he fucking dies. We'll get there later. Anyway.
Will we? I don't know if I'm coming back.
So, she fucks off back to the spring court with Tamlin, and they get engaged, and they live in trauma until the next book. The end.
It's a good book. I can see why she has her whole, her own, fucking stand at Barnes & Noble.
Yeah, tale as old as time.
Like, some of these, I feel like I just gotta fucking read them.
I feel like you would have a fun time laughing at A Court of Thorns and Roses, to be honest.
Yeah.
I want you to read Divine Rivals because I think you'll like it. I want you to read A Court of Thorns and Roses so we can mutually laugh about it.
Yeah, I feel like we should probably read something that we both like for the next video.
I could explain Divine Rivals to you, or you could read it and then we could mutually talk about it.
Is it good?
It's so good.
Okay, that sounds fine.
Oh my god, it's so good. All right, Divine Rivals it is.
I'm just getting mad.
These books are so bad. So bad. I'm still gonna have to explain bad books to you though, because we have fun.
Yeah, it is fun. What is trying to think of one that we mutually liked.
Ember in the Ashes.
Yeah, I can talk about that for days, but
I would love for you to explain Papillon to me.
No. Fuck that book. That dude's a fucking liar.
I feel like you would like Little Thieves. I mean, you like what I would like. Or you would like what I like.
What was the... Is it...
We liked Iron Widow.
Oh my god. Whole book club like Iron Widow.
Oh my god, so good. Yeah. Oh, you would like Gearbreakers. That's like
I was going to say, I think I started Gearbreakers.
Yeah.
But I never finished it. And then, what was the other one where they all have, superpowers?
Oh, Archenemies.
Yeah, Archenemies.
Supernova. No, the first one. Fuck, Renegades.
Renegades.
By Marissa Meyer. That was fun.
Fucking good.
That was so fun. We had a blast.
I was like, this dude's ability shit with the drawing? Mm-hmm. Oh my god.
Oh my god, it was so... We had so much fucking fun reading that trilogy. Yeah. A trilogy I actually finished. Which is rare.
You just read this fucking A Court of Thorns and Roses.
I didn't just read it. I read all
of it. No, I mean, I'm saying
I feel like I just reread it, yeah.
We should do Shadow and Bone watch parties, too.
We should. That would be fun.
Yeah. Buy a second mic.
Yeah, it's time to buy a second mic.
Comments. I just stared off in the space like dead.
The camera stopped recording. It's time to buy a new camera. We hate this thing. It stops recording after either 3 minutes or 12 minutes. There's no... Okay, anyway. Thanks for watching. Leave your stuff down below and... Leave your comments and comments down below and let us know what you want us to talk about next time. Okay.
Not Papillon.
Okay, we love you. Goodbye.
You took my line.
Oh, I'm sorry. Great.
It's fine. You're good.
Okay. Okay, we love you. Bye. Hi, it's me, Trash Can Rachel, and before I go, I have to say thank you for being a friend to my Therapy Feels patrons, and those are Alexander, Allie Magpie, Amanda, Bubble Tea, Cammy, Chris, Claire, Des Robert, DJ Roctopus, Emperor's New Blues, y'all have the most hilarious name. Oh my god, Aaron, Eric, Faror, Harley, Jack and Jill, Johnny, Calais, No K, Casey, Kate, Caitlin, Quinn, Lady Kittybug, Lex, Alice, Peggy Lou, Rain, Reese, Samar, Scarlet, Shiny, and SMK. Thank you all so much for being a friend. And before I go, I have to say thank you for being a friend to my Potato Starch Marxist patrons, and those are AM Angel, Alicia, Amanda, Andy, Angelica, Anita, Artie the Ninth, Ashley, Ava, BB, Beck, Blythe, Bookish Brainrot, Bree, Brian, Caitlin, Carlin, Catherine, Kathy, Chris, CJ, Cole, Colleen, Corwin, Corey, Darren, Deborah, Diet Goth, Dorian, Dorotea, Ebby, Ember, Emily A, Emily L, Emma, Aaron, Hannah C, Hannah T, Harpy Kuro, Haley, Hello There Darling, Ilya Naka, India Inks, JM Tenet, Jay is on Olympus, JT, Jen H, Jen Michelle, Jenny G, Jillian, Jess Pugsley, Kaylee, Kat, Katie, Katya, Kayala, Kendra, Kylie, Laughing Cat Dog, Laura, Lauren B, Library of Scars, Lisa, LP Altvader, Lou C,
Siri, Luna Moth, Lustful Octopus, Martin, Marcella, Marquita, Maz, Malara, MK Books, Molly, James, Nat, Natalie, Never, Nicole, G, Nicole R, Nyan Binary, Paige E, Paige P, Penny Chilling, Foxglove, Pixel Stars, Pyraethion, Rachel B, Rat Sarah, Reba, Rebecca, Ren, Robin, Rosie, Rowan, Other Rowan, Sakoria, Sadie, Samantha, Sarah C, Sarah H, Sarah the Bear, Shamed, Shanae, Shannon, Shayna, Sheena K, Sean. I'm not going to lie to you, all those SH names, I always think I'm going to stumble there and I don't, and I'm really proud of myself. Okay, sorry, moving on. Sophie, Stephanie, Talia, Three Old Dogs, Tina, Toast, Trash Can Teddy, Seb, Valentine, and Writer A. Thank you all so much for being a friend.